that's the word that I can use to describe the scene just now, right? It was an epic scene from Avengers back in 2012. Can you believe it? It's already been 8 years since the epic scene in the silver screen, and it's the one that started it all. Won't you like to have those team of superheroes in your team? Yes, I'm talking about having a team of superheroes in your property investing journey. As a start, you need to assemble a team just like an Avengers. And today's topic, I'm going to address this. Who should be on your team and why? Okay, let's just begin. Number one. Number one, of course, is the most obvious one, is your real estate agents, realtors, property agents, whatever you want to call them. These are the first people that should be on your team because they are the frontliners. They are every day on the field. They are every day on the ground. And their ears are on the ground. So if they any good deals, they will be the one to sniff it out first. You need to keep these people definitely in your team. And keep the good ones in your team. We shall go to the next one, the bankers. This one also very, very important. Bankers will help to, a good banker can help to advise you to how to maximize your loan eligibility. They can actually advise you from, example, a loan of 100,000, how to get extra another 200,000 based on your profile. Help you beautify your profile. If you have a banker or you can choose to use a mortgage broker, no problem. These are the people that you need to keep in your Avengers team. Next one, of course, is the lawyers. Lawyers, I pity them. They are the professionals, but they are most often taken for granted among all the people that I've just mentioned just now. Among the three, the triumvirates, okay, I call them the triumvirates, the real estate agents, the bankers, the lawyers. The lawyers is the one that usually the most taken for granted one. But recent events and also previous events have taught me that these people are the one that is most important, the one that you go to for legal advice. And especially now, during this time, I've received some calls from my clients saying that their tenants is not paying rent. So what are the recourse? They do not have a lawyer friend. So I also, as a realtor, I do need a lawyer to advise me in case there's a legal action, in case there's anything that I need to evict tenant, I need to use the proper way. Okay? A good lawyer can help you make miracles. A good lawyer is also also sometimes expensive, I understand. But you know, they are like an insurance. You buy and you pay, you complain, and you hope you don't use them, okay? Well, this, sorry, lawyer friends, this is not what I meant at all. I hope you understand. You all are very important, okay? So get a good lawyer. A good lawyer, they not only can vet your agreement to protect your interests, they can actually give you very good legal advice. Especially when shit hits the fan. Eviction, legal demand, these are all you need lawyers, okay? So next one, equally important but very, very underappreciated. I've been using these services of property managers for the past, I think, 2 years. And I highly, highly value their services. Property managers, what they do is from their one-stop center, they may actually help you to rent if you want, but you can rent out your property and also pass to them. What they do after that, they will take care of the rental collection. They will take care of your whether your bills are paid or not. Basically, they are like your private secretary. Okay, so if there's any tenant repairs or anything like that, they deal with your property manager. They don't deal with you, so it frees your time to find better deals, to find more deals out there. Okay, your time is worth more than money. You can always find more money but not more time, remember that. So of course they will charge you a small fee. You need to check your property managers, because I can tell there's not many out there who will want to manage this nitty-gritty. It's tedious work, it's tough work. Those who have a lot of properties will understand. Those who have one or two, maybe you still can manage, or you have retired, maybe you still can manage. But if you have a lot, if you want to go far, you have to get some good property managers. They also can advise you on the rental rates, on the sale price if you want, and do a study, enhance your property, much like REITs. You're familiar with REITs, but this is on a small scale for yourself. Property managers are very, very important for the upkeep. of your property and maintaining its value. Next one that you need is the handyman. If you have property managers, you can also ask the property manager to get handyman. But if you want, you can have a good handyman for yourself. Handyman to do a small repairs in the house, leak sink, pipes repair, head repair, shower not working, heater not working, washing machine not working. You get the picture. All these small things, at least your tenant can call you, and or you can call straight away, call the handyman, or you direct, you give them a list when they move in, ask them to call the handyman. The final one, perhaps also the most important, is other investors. Yes, very simple, right? Other property investors who are like-minded people who wants to excel in property investing just like yourself. You need to find these people, because when you have a group of people who's going the same direction, you'll be very surprised how much it will motivate you than rather going alone. It's very tiring if you're going alone, and it's get bored after a while. And failures, no matter, I don't care how tough you are, life will hit you even harder. Life will bring you down to the knees, and failure will bring you down to the knees. I've known a lot of people who actually failed and never touch property after that anymore. But equally, I've known some people who fail and still touch properties because they have a group of people that they can invest together with. You not only get encouragement, you get motivation, you get notes, you also exchange knowledge so that you faster that your investing journey, shorten your learning curve. And one more thing, they also can recommend good people that I've just mentioned above. That's all I have for this video. If you have found this useful, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, YouTube, and also share this video out with your friends and family. Like the page of Property Stories, and I shall see you again next time. Once more, this is Kenny Lee from Property Stories. Bye bye.